And the two faculties that it has is a vivid sense of memory and a fantastic sense of imagination, past and the future. And these two faculties are the tools that we have been given to make use of. But we have, it's like a gun. We can either use it for a good purpose, or we can shoot others and create mayhem. It's like that. So we are creating mayhem with our mind. We are always living either in the past, thinking of what happened back then and how it impacts us, or we are living in the fear of the future. We are not living in the present, in the now.
Welcome to another episode of podcast Wonder Alice. Here I am with my friend Pulkit. He has been like a recent addition to my friendship, and but since I have interacted with him, I have been enlightened on a lot of topics, and I'm very happy that he has been has taken out time to be a part of this podcast. And I welcome Pulkit again here. So Pulkit, can you just introduce yourself, like to our audience, what you do, like anything like about yourself?
Thanks a lot for the awesome introduction, Karthik. I mean, if our topics have been able to enlighten you with our conversations, then it's a great honor for me. What I do work-wise, so I always say, whenever someone asks me what I do, I always ask them back, what do I do for a living or to make a life? So for me, these are two separate things. What I do to make a living is that I work with the Times Group, the Times of India Group, as a product manager, and I siphon off that money to make a life, which is for me traveling and reading and just having a good life, having adventures and exploring everything that life has to offer. So that's me in a nutshell, Karthik. Thanks a lot for the introduction once again.
Nice. Like, that's like interesting. Like when I ask someone, they identify themselves through their occupation, which is like it's counterintuitive, because you know it's not life. This is like it's a money source which you can, you know, employ towards other areas to do something, you know, explore the life itself. I was like coming back, and there was still time to catch my high speed train back to France, and there was a museum, and I thought like, I have time, let's go and explore this museum. And when I went there, there was a painting, okay, and it was an exhibition of museum, and there was a painting in there. And when I saw that painting, I literally cried, you know. It was such a powerful experience, and I'm not a usual guy, I keep my emotions to myself, and like, you know, I'm kind of restrained. But you know, that moment is something, you know, for other people it would be like a mundane thing, or it's not like out of ordinary, but I don't know, it's maybe the whole experience which culminated into that one moment, which actually, you know, is something amazing.
So it's always, you know, I read or heard somewhere there are two kinds of people, tourists and travelers. Tourists are the people who go to popular places and send back postcards of the places they have been to, and then travelers are the people who do not know where they're going and where they've been to, because they just go with the flow. Regard other you know, so let's say if I'm branching out into another stream of beliefs and practices which I regard more than one, but I cannot disregard the other because of that.
You actually can't give preference to everything. That means, you know, there would be contradictions, and that would not be possible. The only solution I can see, disregard everything.
Disregard everything.
You know, we will hit some kind of edge, and then it's gonna all, you know, fall down.
That has to happen. That has to happen. I mean, the way we are destroying nature, that will happen sooner than later. But then, do you really think humans are king? I mean, the turtles have been around, and the bacteria have been around for much, much longer than humans have been. And the kind of environments that these microbes can sustain, humans can't even think of being able to sustain it.
Well, you know, I still have to say they are king, because, you know, king is like kind of like, they have an impact, they can make changes, they can, you know, divert things. The bacteria can't do anything. He's gonna be there, was there in the earlier stages of life, and it's gonna be like after the early stages of life. So there's no impact, it's just there. It's like the sky or it's like the soil, you know, it's just there, you know. What's the impact? Like they are not dominating any, like the turtle is not dominating the sharks, right? You know, it's still just living, it's in the corner side of the earth and just living a peaceful life. You know, things make an impact. They dominate, they expand their kingdoms, and you know, they try to you know, force their culture and their thought process onto others, right? That's called a king. The farming thing, even till now, the basic necessity of life is food.
Yeah.
And the underpaid people are farmers. Mm-hmm. They're the underpaid. Like, you think about it, like, I always kind of compare, like, I'm a software engineer myself. Do I deserve this much of money? You know, it might be imposter syndrome, you know, but you think about it, like, these are the people who are working hard, okay, and they are the underpaid people.
That's true, and that is what the corona pandemic has taught us, hasn't it? The so-called bottom of the chain, the migrant, the laborers, etc., are the people that on whose backs and shoulders and sweat the entire economy and the entire society is based upon. If we don't have the plumbers and the electricians and the rickshaw pullers, where do we go? What do we do? That sort of a thing. So yeah, they are highly underpaid and undervalued, unfortunately. But yeah, they are the ones who are keeping the society going.
So how do you inculcate mindfulness in your life?
Well, honestly, I try to, but have never been too successful with it. Basically, I take mindfulness as just one small, tiny aspect of the entire gamut of spirituality. So I try to live that life. Starting right from my diet. So I used to be an omnivore till last year, and I gave up non-veg food, and now I live on veg food now. So it's a part of the lifestyle change. And mindfulness is just one aspect of it, of the entire thing. Whenever I'm able to realize that my thoughts are wavering and wandering, I just try to pull myself back into the present. And the two faculties that it has is a vivid sense of memory and a fantastic sense of imagination, past and the future. And these two faculties are the tools that we have been given to make use of. But it's like a gun. We can either use it for a good purpose, or we can shoot others and create mayhem. It's like that. So we are creating mayhem with our mind. We are always living either in the past, thinking of what happened back then and how it impacts us, or we are living in the fear of the future. We are not living in the present, in the now. So basically, as Sadhguru says, our faculties have turned against us. And that's what mindfulness teaches. It kind of teaches us to be mindful of what you are thinking, to be in the present, in the now, and not let your present and your future, because that is not life. Life is happening in the present. So don't let those two affect you. So if you're mindful of what you are, what you're doing, of your thoughts, emotions, feelings, your body, and your mind, if you're mindful of these things, then you will sail through life.
There would be a longer period of time that you would be spending in the now. So mm-hmm. How was your experience regarding that?
Never happened for that long, actually. So there is this one practice that I try to use, which is just I close my eyes and then I try to catch my thought. So I ask myself the question, what's the next thought I have? And this is the point where I go from a point of mind to no mind. No mind is when you have no thoughts. So when you actually try to catch your thoughts is when you find that you actually have no thoughts for a moment of time. Enlightenment cannot be chased. It happens. So if you...
It's so counterintuitive in a sense, you know. You don't have any quantifiable thing that there is no fixed path, you know, there is no, like, you have least level one, least level two, there's nothing, you know, you are just blindly following or chasing or going somewhere, or you are just believing on the fact that it may happen, okay?
No,
it's not a guarantee.
No, that's not true. Okay, so for me, speaking for myself, all the spiritual practices and meditations and yoga I do, it's not with an eye on the end goal. There is no destination I have to reach or want to reach. No awakening, no realization, and no enlightenment. I do those things just because they're good for me.
Some kind of space in life. If you are busy, you can't do something new. That's it.
Obviously.
You just have to create a space where things can happen.
lucid dreaming where you can actually control your thoughts and direct, not thoughts, but control your dreams and direct your dreams to ends. Something sort of what happened with Inception. So have you experienced or been able to do that? Because I have not never experienced it.
Like for me it's something like it just happens in a half wakefulness state when you have the dream and you are still aware of the fact that you are sleeping, okay? Then you can gear it towards and that actually that dream is so vivid in sense that it will feel very real in the sense, but you know it's not real. So this
Okay,
is
but then you can control the dream and take it to whatever.
I can gear it towards the emotion I feel it should go. If, for example, if I like if I see a person which I like a lot in a sense.
But once you die, you want to say that that is not you or your life. What happens after you die?
I have no idea. Like I don't have the knowledge or the experience to attach with it. If I
Obviously,
die and I see something
you have
more,
never died
then I
anyway.
accept it. That's it. If I become a different personality and I can see that it's happening, because if you think about it, you can see that changes in personality. Like sometimes you were omnivore, now it's vegetarian. There's a change in your thought process, right? That's how you have branched out to something else. And maybe if I die, I branch out to something, a being which has like more capacity to analyze things, then I accept that. But until then, I'm gonna refrain from like having that ideology that they would be reincarnation. I ain't gonna take that chance. You know, I will live my life now completely fulfilling, and I wanna do what I want to do in this moment.
That's the best way. So again, mindfulness is doing what you are doing right now and putting your 100% focus on it.
Exactly.
Never is it said that if you want to attain enlightenment, then you have to leave off the world and live a life of asceticism and go off into the Himalayas. No, you can attain enlightenment and realization while doing the things you are doing in this world right now. You can be going off to the office or studying or meditating or making
Exactly.
podcasts
You
and attain
know,
enlightenment.
if enlightenment is something which is a birthright of everybody, okay, then the farmer and the king is eligible for that fact. I had a near-death experience, okay? So in that near-death experience, my mind was blank, okay? So kind of I was drowning in that, okay? So I was in a trip, I was drowning, and people saw me, I was drowning, but in my head I was blank. They were saying that you were like flailing your hand, or you were kind of doing all those steps, or you were also shouting, but I have no recollection of it. My mind was blank, okay? And I realized that what if I die and there's only blankness? It just ends, you know? It's just a power of button and switch off. Like hard disk and the CPU are fried. Now it's not gonna turn off. There's nothing beyond that.
As with any practices, religion came out as a religion was started as a great thing, but humans diluted it, corrupted it. The same thing, spirituality is a great thing, but then if you start killing people in the name of spirituality, so humans,
Because
it's
like
how
this has
humans
been
take
like
those
an
beautiful things and what
amazing
they make out
podcast,
of it.
and so we talked about like from traveling to spirituality, and in fact we had were talking about spirituality a lot, and we and these had their branches of like that had effect on traveling and then effect on your doing your daily life, living your daily life, and just it was just a wonderful experience with you. And this podcast, like for the audience, is available in a lot of sources like Google Podcast, iTunes, Spotify. So it's available at a lot places. I will add those links in the description, okay? And thanks for tuning in, and we will be back with a new episode of Wonderalist Podcast.